have, in fact, perused some newsreels from the Schwarzenegger Library.
Hold it. The Schwarzenegger Library?
Yes, the Schwarzenegger Presidential Library. Wasn't he an actor when
you... Stop. He was president?
Yes. Even though he was not born in this country, his popularity at the time caused the 61st Amendment, which states that...
I don't want to know.
The California recall circus just got bigger.
And now it's time for me to give something back to California. And this is what this is all about. Thank you.
Bad idea.
Arnold, the actor, is in.
Hey, Arnold.
Hold it, Willis.
And so's the guy who played Arnold.
I'm announcing.
There's a pundit, a pornographer, lots of politicians and personalities lining up to be on the ballot.
If you love California, you'll vote for Angelini.
There are some people that are running because they're crazy, and they have no sense of reality.
Is it democracy in action or the beginning of political chaos?
I will pump up Sacramento.
Arnold, thank you, buddy.
Tonight, Revenge of the Voters.
From ABC News. This is Nightline. Reporting from Washington, Ted Koppel.
You have to wonder what they're thinking in Baghdad. So these are the people, Iraqis must be saying to one another, who are going to teach us about democracy and representational government. Even if we could explain that California is at times a universe unto itself, the political process that is now unfolding in our most populous state bears a greater resemblance to a train wreck than to anything we might recommend to another country. Just to bring everybody up to speed, over 500 people have now declared themselves possible candidates to replace Governor Gray Davis in the event that he is recalled in a vote that is now scheduled to take place on October 7th. Of those 500 plus, 9 have actually filled out the necessary forms, paid the fee, and submitted it all to the Secretary of State's office. Democrats weren't going to dignify the process by running any candidates. The Lieutenant Governor, Cruz Bustamante, summed it up a little while ago when he said, "I will not participate in any way other than to urge voters to reject this expensive perversion of the recall process." That was just before Mr. Bustamante had a change of heart and announced today that he is now running for governor too. The man who gave momentum to the recall effort, Republican Congressman Darrell Issa, who plowed $1.7 million of his own money into the campaign so that he could run for governor, today announced that he is pulling out, but that it has nothing to do with Arnold Schwarzenegger coming into the fray. It is, as Judy Muller now reports from Los Angeles, one large chaotic mess.
Following this recall election campaign requires a scorecard that changes by the hour. Republican Arnold Schwarzenegger had barely entered the fray.
Well, I'm very excited to be here today. Very, very excited.
When the Republican who started the recall in the first place dropped out. The Terminator has Democrats running scared as well. What was supposed to be a united front for Governor Gray Davis is rapidly crumbling. The Lieutenant Governor announced his candidacy today, even as he tried to project a semblance of loyalty.
I'm here to tell everyone to vote no on the recall and yes on Bustamante.
The Democrat considered the best bet to win, Senator Dianne Feinstein, has said she will not run, but some party members reportedly want her to reconsider. More Republicans may jump in. Former baseball commissioner Peter Uberoff, for one. Political columnist Arianna Huffington is running as an independent.
I'm not, to say the least, a conventional candidate.
And then there are all those others. From a porn publisher...
Vote for a smut peddler who cares.
...to a porn star with a unique plan for deficit reduction.
If we do a 20% tax on all plastic surgery, especially breast implants, you know, in Beverly Hills alone, we'll be making millions of dollars.
In fact, more than 500 people have taken out candidate filing papers. Not all will file, of course, but the ease of running 65 signatures and $3,500 has created something of a carnival atmosphere.
We look like a third world country. And if you look at some of the people who are signing up to run, it's a circus. and this is becoming a sideshow for international television.
But it's no circus for the poor county registrars who have to certify all those candidate filing papers, all those voter signatures, and gear up for an election no one had planned for. The filing deadline is Saturday. The election is October 7th.
And this is putting us in a scenario where we have less than 3 weeks to find our polling locations, get them secured, then start hiring the poll workers. Going to the press with the sample ballots is 2 weeks later than usual, so we're concerned about people getting their sample ballot on time.
Adding to the confusion, at least a dozen legal challenges to the recall filed in state and federal courts, including one that asked for a delay in the election to give all precincts time to get their voting machinery up and running.
Late today, the California Supreme Court denied several of those cases, but many legal challenges remain, not to mention logistical hurdles. After the hanging Chad fiasco in the 2000 presidential election, California started the switch over from punch card ballots to an inked mark ballot. But the new ones won't be ready by October 7th.
We had a public retirement party for Chad, but now we've decided, Chad, we have to bring him back for one more encore.
The problem of dusting off the old equipment pales next to the deadline pressure of putting together a ballot once all the names are in 2 days from now.
We have capacity for about 225 candidates. After that, we don't have any ballot capacity and any way to count an election on automatic equipment.
Which would mean a hand count. She is hopeful the final number of candidates will total fewer than 100, but in this atmosphere, no one's making any bets. The California chaos is being watched very carefully by other states with recall provisions on their books.
A lot of states have laws on the books, like California's, that are 90 years old, that have a lot of glitches in them that no one's ever looked at, and it's hard to straighten everything out in a few weeks when you're doing litigation under fire. That's not the best way to deal with problems that have built up over decades.
But the recall initiative is playing out in California is no accident. Voters in this enormous state feel disconnected from their elected leaders and often take matters into their own hands with ballot initiatives, from property tax limits to political term limits.
All of these direct democracy things, while they often deal with real problems and real issues, they're also kind of sledgehammer solutions, and the unexpected consequences are often quite significant.
Schrag, who wrote Paradise Lost, California's Experience, America's Future, thinks voters in the Golden State want golden results at little cost to themselves.
And the most fundamental thing, I think, in California is the fact that we all want a high level of services. We all want great schools. We all want great roads and so on. I'm not sure that we're quite ready yet to understand how much we have to pay to get those things.
And so when things go wrong, it's throw the bum out. And some want to replace him with the candidate who embodies an image of leadership, that old can-do spirit.
There were times where people said it can never be done, that an Austrian farm boy can come over to America and get into the movie business and be successful in the movie business. They said we cannot pronounce your name, you cannot speak English well, and your body is overdeveloped. And you know what happened? I became the highest paid entertainer in the world.
That merging of entertainment and politics is a powerful force. Arnold Schwarzenegger, for example, has almost no political record, which may actually help him.
I distrust people who have been in politics for a long time, and I think that it would be refreshing to have somebody like Schwarzenegger.
I think the rest of the country has to realize that something's going on here, a shift in the almost the anthropology of politics. A fusion of entertainment values, of direct democracy, of instant communication, of celebrity values. All these things are coalescing to shift the way Americans get political information or expect to exercise their political franchise.
And that craving for immediate gratification is hardly limited to the West Coast.
If you took the state of California and renamed it the state of America, you wouldn't have to adjust much. This culture of California, which extends from Maine to Georgia, if we're on the East Coast, embodies all the elements, all the tensions, all the peoples, all the possibilities of the larger American experience.
A rather elegant way of saying, look before you laugh. I'm Judy Muller for Nightline in Los Angeles.